bridge to the land of rest. Come, my yoke is easy, children, listen and be blessed. Take your brother by the hand, encourage the weak to stand, waiting on that golden strand. Come and be my
About 17 years, Tracy said, Masterpiece Quartet traveled around the area and sang for the Lord, and the group retired in 2019, but Hendrix Trio was so kind to let us kind of have a bit of a, are you going to use a mic or anything? Good job.
we don't need a mic.
Let us get together and try a little. This particular version of Masterpiece Quartet hasn't sung or practiced a song in about 6 years, so what could go wrong? Right? Marlon, Tracy, Kevin, Daryl's back there. This is Masterpiece Quartet. Let's have some fun.
Moses led God's children
turn.
Take a breath, Marlon.
Go and tell somebody what is done for you. Go tell somebody what the Lord can do. How we gave you victory, how we brought you through. Go tell somebody what the Lord can do.
Come on, Marlon.
There once was a blind man, the Lord gave him sight. He had to tell somebody, he couldn't keep it quiet. Once he's touched you, you'll never be the same. Go and tell somebody, you gotta praise his name.
But go tell somebody what he's done for.
There was a cripple sitting by the road. One day he met Jesus, he was then made whole. And I can see him walking, and then he starts to run. He had to tell somebody what the Lord has done. Go tell somebody
what he's done for you. Go tell somebody what the Lord can do.
How he gave you
victory, how he brought you through. Go tell somebody what the Lord can do.
Go tell somebody
what he's done for you. Go tell somebody what the Lord can do.
How he gave you
victory, how he brought you through.
Daryl Gann, sing the Lighthouse, brother.
I want to sing this song tonight in honor of my late sister, Marlon's late wife. She's with the Lord now, and she always loved to hear this song. There's a lighthouse on a hillside.
Yeah.
Oh, well, can he save me? Could he love me? Would he take me? Did he
really? Can he? Could he? Would he? Yes, he can. He could. He would. He did.
You believe that tonight? Amen.
Can he
save
me? Could he?
Well, some bad morning when the sun is
I'm going to take a pause real quick and let y'all be blessed while they're getting set up. Now, Brother Bobby, did we ever find anybody to pass these around, or am I just going to appoint somebody?
I guess you're appointing.
Okie dokie. Well, let's see. Any, meeny, miny, moe? Moe. How about Michael Spanhanks? Come on up here, grab you one of these. Hey, why LaVonda's daddy? Come up here and help pass this. You go down that aisle. LaVonda's daddy, come right here. I have two more on that other side, so don't think y'all's getting by with it. All right. Let's see. Now, I only have four bags, so I've got an aisle here. I tell you what, y'all scoot over one aisle. You go ahead and come here. I wasn't very organized, was I? I was too busy worshiping. All right, I need somebody right here. Come up here, Bubba. I got to put y'all on. To work. Anybody want to just do this, or I'm just going to have to make y'all do the come here. It's where my feelers are at. Josh. Josh, if you don't mind, go down that side aisle. Now then, I don't want anybody to miss their blessing. I want all four of you men to make sure everybody gets served. This is like you're passing out candy. The only thing is, that's right, only thing is, when you give into this bag, you are going to get back 100-fold. I can guarantee you. You've already been blessed, right? Now then, we went to a little church, wasn't but about maybe 15, 20 people there, and the pastor got up and said, we're going to receive an offering for this group, and we was, you know, about 7 hours from home, and I thought, Lord, this is just in your hands. He said, I want you to put whatever God put in the very beginning of your mind, the very first thought of what you thought about giving, and then you shoved that to the side, and you said, no, you give that very first thought. That's what he called it, the very first thought for the blessing of God. And do you know it's been one of the best offerings we ever received? So I'm asking you tonight, all of these groups came, they've donated their time, every one of these people up here. Now, I fed them lunch today, but thank you. But a hamburger don't take you very far down the road. I am just asking you all, that very first thought that came in your mind, you put that in the bag, and I can promise you, God will supply the rest. Amen? Dig as deep as you can. If we run out of room in these bags, we can always dump them out in this guitar case up here and come back to you again. I want y'all to be blessed because I have realized that if I want a blessing, I give. Maybe not monetarily always, but I give. How many of you have received a blessing by giving? Let me see every hand in here. All right, guys, I want y'all just to play something fast. Get up, go to town. These guys over here is our band. I want y'all just to, ain't they doing a good job? All right, pass the bags, guys. Play something. Oh, Brother Bobby. Give him a song. He knows how to play offering songs. There you go. Before these guys start singing, I want y'all to know Donnie Hooten is the fellow that I'm always sharing on Facebook. How many of y'all are my Facebook friends? Yeah. Uh-oh, I need somebody in the top for the offering. I'm going to let the Hootens sing, and they're going to help receive that offering up in the balcony. That's a bird's eye view up there. I was going to let you know, So do I have somebody going up there? Daddy? Who else? Just one? All right. Thank y'all. Thank you, Renee. I forgot about y'all up there, too. Y'all ain't got no lights on. I can see somebody waving a hand there. You look at them. Y'all turn around and say hey to the balcony. Yeah. We're glad y'all are here. Y'all's our overflow. The Hootons promote gospel music in Shreveport. They bring in some of the top-notch groups, Gold City, Kingsman. Who's your next big name group?
Down East Boys.
If you know anything about Southern gospel music, those are all name brand, all right? You can go over there for a love offering, and I want y'all to watch.
My favorite group, the Hootons, are there every month, too.
Yeah, well, now what'd you say?
I said my favorite group, the Hootons, are there
every month. My favorite group, the Hootons, are there, too. He's the promoter.
I don't have anything to give you.
He is one of the easiest guys to work with. I'll just tell y'all right now. He's real easy going. I love for him to run the sound. Sometimes I just have to tell him, just calm down. But I think he's been doing a fantastic job tonight. And if you had to set up sound and put up with these 45 people up here, you would be praising God for Donnie Hooton. I can tell you right now, put your hands together for the Hootons.
Well, I'm satisfied.
Satisfied with Jesus.
I'm satisfied.
Satisfied with Jesus. Said he would be my comfort. Said he would be my guide. Well, I looked at my hands. My hands looked new. I looked at my feet and they did too. Ever since that wonderful day, my soul's been satisfied.
Well, I'm satisfied.
Satisfied with Jesus.
I'm satisfied.
Satisfied with Jesus. Said he would be my comfort. Said he would be my guide. Well, looked at my hands. My hands looked new. I looked at my feet and made it too. Ever since that wonderful day, my soul's been satisfied.
Well, the Lord moves in mysterious ways. His wonders to perform. You know, he plants his feet on every step, then he rides on every storm. He fixed my feet for running boys, and then my eyes, he opened up wide.
He fixed my tongue so I could say, praise God, I'm satisfied.
Well, I'm satisfied.
Satisfied with Jesus.
I'm satisfied.
Satisfied with Jesus. Said he would be my comfort. Said he would be my guide. Well, looked at my hands. My hands looked new. I looked at my feet and made it too. But ever since that wonderful day, my soul's been satisfied.
Well, it was way down yonder in the valley, boys, I was wandering all alone. And he was there, I met my Jesus, and you know he claimed me for his own. His arms all around me there, then he drew me up to his side.
Oh yes, I'm satisfied.
I'm satisfied.
Satisfied with Jesus.
I'm satisfied.
Satisfied with Jesus. Said he would be my comfort. Said he would be my guide. Well, looked at my hands. My hands looked new. Looked at my feet. Ever since that wonderful day, my soul's been satisfied.
Well, I'm satisfied.
Satisfied with Jesus.
So satisfied.
Satisfied with Jesus. Said he would be my comfort. Said he would be my guide. Well, looked at my hands. My hands looked new. Looked at my feet. Paid it too. Ever since that wonderful day, my soul's been satisfied. I'm gonna live forever. I'm gonna die, no never. Jesus died. a tree for me, and I'm gonna live forever. I'm gonna live forever. I'm gonna die, no, never. Jesus died on a tree for me, and I'm gonna live forever.
I know my name will never be hung in lights upon a marquee, because Jesus Christ hung on a tree. I'm gonna live forever. King of the Jews, the cross proclaimed, while those around him mocked his name. It was for me that he bore all the shame, so I could live forever.
I'm gonna live forever. I'm gonna die, no, never. Jesus died on a tree for me, and I'm gonna live forever.
I know my name will never be written down in history, but Jesus wrote my name in that book of life, and that's enough for me. Someday he's coming back again, and nothing for me will be the same. I'll have a new body and a brand new.
Isn't it good to be in the house of the Lord tonight? Have you enjoyed the group so far? How about the choir? Have you enjoyed the choir? I still think y'all can do better than that. Have you enjoyed the choir tonight? There you go. Well, I don't want to take long, but I want to tell you who we are. This one right here is 12 years old. He will be 13 next month. He is my mini-me. Everything I do, he does. Even combs his hair like his daddy. Y'all pray for him because he wants to be like me. His name is Eli. Make him welcome. And this tall drink of water right here is 14 years old. Everywhere we go, the ladies come to him and talk to him. Me and Eli ain't figured it out yet. I don't know if it's the chin. Somebody told me the other day it's the boots. I don't know what it is, but old, young, it don't matter. They flock to this one right here. He stands tall, and he's proud of it, too. Make him welcome. His name is Zach Hooten. And my name is Donnie Hooten, and that makes up the Hootens. And like Rhonda said, we do put on concerts down in Shreveport. But I tell you what, I love the Lord with all my heart. I remember as a 9-year-old child walking down an aisle and giving my life to Jesus Christ. And I've never been the same since. Because when you're touched by the Master, nothing is ever the same again. We want to sing this one right here, one of my favorite songs. It simply says, He touched me.
Mm-hmm.
of Jesus touched me.
Mistreated, rebuked, scorned, talked about sure as you're born. I've been up, down, almost to the ground.
Long as I've got King Jesus.
Long as I got King Jesus.
Long as I've got.
Don't need nobody else. I've been lied on, cheated, talked about, mistreated, rebuked, scorned, talked about sure as you're born. I've been up. Down, almost to the ground.
Long as I've got King Jesus.
Long as I got King Jesus.
Long as I've got.
Don't need nobody else. I don't need nobody else. I don't need nobody else. No mother, father, sister, brother. No doctor, lawyer, preacher. Teacher.
Long as I've got King Jesus.
Long as I got King Jesus.
Long as I've got.
Don't need nobody else. I don't need nobody else. I don't need nobody else. No mother, father, sister, brother, or no doctor, lawyer, preacher, teacher.
I've got King Jesus.
Long as I got King Jesus.
Long as I've got.
Don't need nobody else. Do you know what I mean? I've been lied on, cheated, talked about, mistreated, rebuked, scorned, talked about sure as you're born. I've been up, down, almost to the ground. As I got King Jesus, long as I got King Jesus, I know he's a burden bearer.
I know he's a heavy load sharer. He'll be a bridge over water. He'll be a doctor and a lawyer. He'll be a friend when you're friendless. He'll be your brother when you're motherless. He'll be your bread when you're hungry. He'll be your brother when you're lonely. Long as I got King Jesus, long as I got King Jesus, long, I got it. Jesus, I've got it. Jesus, I've got it. Jesus, I've got it. Jesus, he's the lily of the valley. He's the bright morning star. He's the sweet rose of Sharon. He's the great I am.
I've got King Jesus.
Long as I got King Jesus.
Long, long, long as I've got.
Don't need nobody else.
These guys are making their way to the stage. We sang at an outdoor venue not too long ago. And are y'all going to do your Acapulco song? Y'all's anthem song, y'all's God Bless America, Do Whatever, or whatever that song is that y'all sang down there at the GMAAAA convention. You weren't planning on it?
We weren't planning on it.
Well, Sister Rhonda's telling you right now, I want you to begin with that song, all right? Can you do that for me?
You got it?
It's okay.
He's got it.
These guys give of their time a lot, and we went down to Tawakoni. Anybody know where Tawakoni's at? Out there on the lake, and they had us a fundraiser for the fire department, and it was as hot as blazes out there. And I thought I was going to catch on fire. And they had us out for underneath, I'm telling you, it was awful. These guys came, and about that time, here come the flag people across the road, and here come these people marching. And my heart was just touched. I know I'm throwing them a curveball. I want y'all to sing this song, then whatever else you got, you're perfectly fine. I'm giving you these extra 3 minutes. Ain't y'all happy? Y'all's
since
happy.
Since you did that. We were honored to sing the national anthem for the Texas Rangers on the 10th anniversary of 9/11.
All right.
And they were playing. They happened to be playing the New York Yankees that day. And people started calling us and saying, "Oh, God's going to use you to mighty way." And I'm going, "It's the national anthem, folks. What do you mean God's going to use us in a mighty way?" I had no idea. We went out and sang the national anthem, and just before the seventh inning, it rained. Uh-huh. And it was a rain out, and people were hiding under the bleachers and all that kind of stuff. And we were all standing there side by side, and someone recognized us, and they said, "Sing something else for us." So we sang the gospel at Texas Stadium while people were hiding. And I said, "Lord, I will never doubt you again."
Yep.
We're going to honor and glorify you wherever we go the best we can.
Make them welcome, Exalt Quartet.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still. Satan's that star-spangled banner yet wave. O'er the land of the free and the home of the
heard us in concert before, you know I love Christmas. I just do. And I think it is a crying shame that we only sing Christmas songs at Christmas time, like from Thanksgiving to the 25th of December. I think we ought to celebrate Christmas all year long, because if there hadn't been a birth, there couldn't have been a death. And if there hadn't have been a death, there couldn't have been a resurrection. And if there hadn't been a resurrection, there wouldn't be a coming again. So we want to glorify God with celebrating a little Christmas.
Look up, fear not, the angel said. Behold, the Messiah's come, the one of whom you've read. And as they spoke to men that day, the heavenly host around the throne joined in to say, glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, goodwill to men. Heavenly angels announce his arrival in the little town of Bethlehem. Hallelujah to the Lord, sing holy, he was born to save the world from sin. Glory to God in the highest glory, hallelujah to the Lord, amen. And still today the wise men come, offering their praise to God's anointed one. And as they spoke, their heartfelt love, and this glorious sound was on my ear from up above. Glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, goodwill to men. Heavenly angels announce his arrival in the little town of Bethlehem. Hallelujah to the Lord, sing holy, he was born to save the world from sin. Glory to God in the highest glory, hallelujah to the Lord, amen. Sing glory to glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, goodwill to men. Heavenly angels announce his arrival in the little town of Bethlehem. Hallelujah to the Lord, sing holy, he was born to save the world from sin. Glory to God in the highest glory, hallelujah to the Lord, amen. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, goodwill to men. Heavenly angels announce his arrival in the little town of Bethlehem. Hallelujah to the Lord, sing holy, he was born to save the world from sin. Glory to God in the highest glory, hallelujah to the Lord, amen. Hallelujah to the Lord, sing holy, he was born to save the world from sin. Glory to God in the highest glory. Glory, glory to God in the highest glory, hallelujah to the Lord, amen, 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 amen. Glory to God in the highest.
We're Exalt Quartet. That's Jason Lawley over the end. That's Marty McKee standing beside him, and we have the pleasure of having two high tenors in our group. They're, high tenors are hard to find, let me tell you. And when Marty had a heart attack, I went to the hospital. I said, you better get ready, better, because I'm not looking for another high tenor. Standing beside me is Eric Garrett. He sings baritone. My mind, it comes and goes.
And this is Steve Bell. He sings the lady's part, not.
We've had a good time tonight, and maybe you came with a smile on your face and in your heart when you came through the door. I don't know. Maybe you're you're hiding behind that smile, because inside, your heart's breaking. And you just don't know. Does anybody really care? I want you to know, whether you're smiling because you have something to smile for, or you're hiding behind that smile, His eye is on you.
Why do I feel discouraged? Why do the shadows come?
And why does my heart feel lonely and long for heaven and home?
When Jesus is my portion, His eye is on the sparrow, and I know He watches me. His eye is on the sparrow, and I know He watches me. So I sing because I'm happy, and I sing because I'm free. Yeah. His eye is on the sparrow, and I know watches me, and I sing because I'm happy. So I sing because I'm free. Yeah. His eye is on the sparrow, and I know He watches, and I know He watches, and I know He watches me.
All day long, I've been thinking about the drive home. 2.5 hours. I'm tired. How would it be if the Lord just came and took us home?
I'm gonna be gone,
gonna be gone.
In the twinkling of an eye. I'm gonna be
gone.
Time to say goodbye. I'm gonna be gone.
Gonna be gone.
Could be while I'm singing the song. I'm gonna be gone,
and it won't be long.
I'm gonna be
gone.
This old world's not getting better. Every day it's getting worse. So much fighting and confusion going on down here on earth. But I don't let it bother me, 'cause I'm not here to stay. I know my Lord is coming soon, and I'll be called away.
I'm gonna be gone,
gonna be gone.
In the twinkling of an eye. I'm gonna be gone. Won't have time to say goodbye. I'm gonna be gone. Could be while I'm singing the song. I'm gonna be gone and it won't be long. I'm gonna be gone. I'm gonna be gone. In the twinkling of an eye. I'm gonna be gone. Won't have time to say goodbye. I'm gonna be gone.
I can say with calm assurance, this old world is not my home. One of these days you're gonna look for me.
Praise God!
I'm gonna be gone.
Said it could happen in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye. You know, I'm really tired of watching the news, because nobody knows what's true and what's not and what's fake and what's real and all that kind of stuff. Can you imagine if ABC and CBS was there at the Garden Tomb? How they would have reported that? I don't even want to go there. That would be a real mess. But you know what? We're glad to say to you today, there's good news from Jerusalem. Jesus was a man who was not like any other. He preached about judgment and a kingdom soon to be. Oh, the people had never heard words like these. He stirred up the scribes and the Pharisees. So they began to plot against God's one and only Son.
They led him before the courts in the halls of Pilate. In a trial they mocked and condemned this righteous man. Pilate listened to the crowd and he knew they lied, but when he heard the people cry, crucify, he tried, but he couldn't wash the blood from his guilty hands.
Jesus died on a lonely hill they called Mount Calvary. They laid him in a tomb and the stone sealed him inside. But 3 days later, when the women came, shocked and excited, when he reached his grave, they ran back to town and everybody heard them cry.
Good news from Jerusalem, across on a hill where the debt was paid, an empty tomb where his body lay, a small upper room where they saw he was glorified. Good news from Jerusalem, he's alive, he's alive, he's alive. Good news from Jerusalem, he's alive, he's alive, he's alive.
Oh, 2,000 years have passed since he ascended. Wars rage on in a world so lost in sin.
Troubles and trials on every hand. Peace is coming to the promised land. When the king comes back, we'll shout it again and again. Good news from Jerusalem. A sign in the sky every eye can see. A lamb that will last for eternity. A throne for a king who had long been prophesied. Good news from Jerusalem. He's alive, he's alive, he's alive. Good news, he's alive. A sign in the sky every eye can see. A crown that will last for eternity. The throne for a king who had long been prophesied. Good news from Jerusalem.
Good news from Jerusalem.
Good news from Jerusalem. He's alive, he's alive, he's alive. Good news, he's alive. Good news, he's alive.
About joy. You can have joy when you're happy because you know God's in control. And you can be, have joy when you're sad because you know God is in control. Let's sing about that joy tonight.
Jesus washed away my sin.
Forever after joy.
Man, we didn't have an encore on that. But I'm telling, I'm having church up in here, and while these guys are getting ready, getting set up, I'm going to tell y'all something. I remembered, how many of y'all a while ago when I was walking up by here saw my sweater catch on that altar? And I was almost up on stage I was almost to that first step when I realized that it was still hanging back there. Well, we were promoting a concert over at Grandpa's place. How many of y'all ever got to go to Grandpa's place and we were promoting over there? It was out in the country, over in Hope, Patmos area. And I got this bling bling skirt on, you see. And so they had these chairs that all connected together, and it's them bottom chairs, you sit in them, they're real comfortable. But Sister Rhonda is going to go up and announce the next group. And I'm sitting, I think I was sitting in this chair here because I grabbed my skirt, grabbed a hold of that little hooky-dooey that other chair would have hooked to had there been another chair there. And I promised y'all, and it was a real full skirt with bling bling on the bottom. And I had got all the way. I mean, it was, did I not? Who was there, Renessa, Bobby?
We're witness.
Yeah, they was. And I dragged the chair about 6 inches before I realized that I had something hanging on me. Well, sometimes, now y'all know me. Little things and little lessons teach me something, if I let it. I was thinking about that this afternoon. Sometimes there's things that are attached to us that we don't even realize that could be keeping us from the blessings of God. And I want to be so sensitive to the Spirit of God. I went through a period of time when I couldn't cry. I wasn't on medication. Sometimes medication does that to you. I wasn't on any kind of medication. It was just the enemy coming against me, Brother Johnny Farmer. And if you know me, when you get to heaven, I ain't going to have no more tears. But if I'm down here and I feel the Spirit of the Lord, I'm going to cry. And I got up and I testified. In our church, we testified. I'm hurrying. In our little church, we testified. We stood and testified. And I stood up one time and I said, I get so frustrated because all I can do is cry when I feel the Spirit of the Lord. I said that. And Dustin, for about 6 months, I went without feeling the Spirit of God. And I told the Lord, if you will take this from me and let me feel you and cry, I'll never get puffed up again. And my eyes will never be dry again. And I will never be embarrassed. I was tired of carting that thing around that was attached to me. And I didn't even hardly know it. But you listen to what I'm saying tonight. If you've got sin that's weighing you down, and you don't know what to do, I come to tell you that Jesus tonight can set you free from that thing we're dragging around. Amen? I want you to listen as they minister tonight. Make them welcome, Truth Infusion.
Children of Eden, sinners and thieves, come wash in the river, come drink your
Sing a song that we've really seen the Lord minister to a lot of people with this song for the last couple of years. And Wes, this is a kind of a personal testimony for him. Loving my Jesus. Come on, brother.
Thank you.
September. In September, we were in the Pine Bluff State Prison Unit. In about 20 minutes, about 150 inmates are going to come into a chapel with us for a Sunday morning service. Right about that time, 20 minutes till, God put a song on Wes's heart. I'm going to pull my phone out so I can read some scripture, Miss Rhonda. I'm not taking a Facebook selfie or anything here. Put a song on Wes's heart that he felt like we were supposed to do that day. We had never sung it or played it before. And I started trying to remember words, and Wes was singing it to Dwayne so he could figure out how to play it. It was just the Holy Spirit time. It's a song about a prison break. It's a good place to sing a song about a prison break. It was right there. The guards were going. I'm going to read you some scripture, and then we'll do this song, and we'll be done. Those who sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, bound in affliction and irons, because they rebelled against the words of God and despised the counsel of the Most High. Therefore, He brought down their heart with labor, and they fell down, and there was no one to help. Why would you do that, God? Well, here's the next verse. Then they cried out to the Lord in their trouble, and He saved them out of their distresses. And He brought them out of the darkness and the shadow of death and broke their chains in pieces. Oh, that men would give thanks to the Lord for His goodness and for His wonderful works to the children of men. I want to read one more verse. I love this verse. For He has broken the gates of bronze and cut the bars of iron in two. This is a song called Prisoners. Listen.
Thank you.
Wash away my sin and tell him what key gear he needs to give us.
Give us an F.
Now you can hit that introduction, and we're going to sing this Acapulco. All right, hit the introduction.
Celebrating 31 years of ministry this year, welcome to the stage, the Hendrix Trio.
Away my sin, nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. Time to pray.
Fretting away. 'Cause if you got time to worry, you got time to pray.
Yes, if you got time to worry, you got time to
I love directing traffic. I told him I ain't bossy, I just make good suggestions. You want us to come over there by you, baby?
I'd love it if you
well,
would.
Well, now, you know, Facebook is back there being recorded by the church, so y'all can go to the Free Life Church and attach that to your Facebook, but I think he wants us over here. Well, the reason this tall feller cup of water is following me around is because he was part of the Hendrix Trio for many years, two times. He'd go take a little bit. He's a rerun and a rerun and a rerun. And I'm telling you, he had to actually go to school to be a mortician. I told him I was a travel agent at that time, and Brother Bobby, if their doctors couldn't fix them, we'd just haul them right on down to Brother Dustin, and he'd put the last smile on your face. And if you needed somebody to sing at the funeral, we could do that too. And I could even fly in the family. We was an all service. Well, we had lots of good times, didn't we? We could stand here all night and tell about all the funny things that happened. My sister-in-law and brother-in-law are up in the balcony. And Renee was part of our group whenever Mary died, went to heaven, the first girl that sang with us 31 years ago. And when she died, we were devastated. And the Lord spoke to a group and said, cousins of Dustin's, and said, go with Bobby and Rhonda. They did. And then their cousin married my sister-in-law. And the rest is history. We're here tonight because of the grace of God. And I've always said, I'm not a preacher. I'm not really a teacher, but I know one thing. I've been touched by the hand of God, and I have a voice, and I can share the gospel, whether it's by testimony or by a note. I'm going to do what I'm called to do. And we feel like that we can be encouragers so that you can go further and you can be encouraged and get your little battery charged so that you can go out and face this world that is draining on the batteries. Amen? Dustin, this is your signature song. Do you remember it? All right. I want y'all to make Dustin May welcome to the stage.
Thank you.
1,000 pens could never write the story. 1,000,000 words could never speak the whole. To tell you of our Savior's matchless glory in bringing me salvation for my soul. The voice of living waters could not speak it. Oh, the songs of countless angels could not tell. The glory of the everlasting Father, who sent his Son to save our soul from hell. He's sweeter to me than he's ever been. More precious he daily has grown. Although I have failed you, he has become the dearest friend I've ever known. Oh, he's sweeter to me than he's ever been. More precious he daily has grown.
Dustin May. He blew more speakers than I can count. Back in 2020, y'all know my testimony. I'm going to be real quick. I was diagnosed with T-cell lymphoma. I had this stuff all over my face. Y'all didn't know what it was. I didn't know what it was, but I told everybody every time we'd go to church, whenever God heals me of this, you're going to hear me all the way from Texarkana. You're going to hear me as much as I'm praying about it. You're going to hear me praise about it. So I'm here tonight to exclaim to you that I've been healed by the power of God. And I am a living testimony. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
We're going to sing a song that is the title song of our CD. And this is the last song. And I don't know if y'all know it or not, but we don't have words or anything back there, so I didn't know if y'all knew that. Do you know that? Shake your head yes if you knew. All right, sweetie, I just want to make sure, because I knew I was going to be in hot water if that next song wasn't up there. Go ahead, Brother Bobby. Tell it like it was.
Nobody ever talks about the way it used to be, where tears were on the altars from sinners on their knee. The preacher didn't worry about politically correct. It wasn't his opinion, it was what that Bible said. We can try to pick and choose the one size still fits all. There is no brand new high-tech way to make them heed the call.
It's time to tell it like it was, 'cause that's the way it is. If we want it like they had it, we gotta do it like they did. Rich and wrong is wrong and right is right.
There is no gray, just black and white.
If it took the blood back then, it still does. We've just gotta tell it like it was.
And is it any wonder that we're in the shape we're in? The church will only say it if we're sure it won't offend.
John may have baptized Jesus, but he isn't watered down.
There's still power in his word to turn this world around.
It's time to tell it like it was, 'cause that's the way it is. If we want it like they had it, we gotta do it like they did. Preaching wrong is wrong and right is right.
There is no gray, just black and white.
And if it took the blood back then, it still does. We just gotta tell it like it was.
Oh, it's time to tell it like it was, 'cause that's the way it is.
If we want it like they had it, we gotta do it like they did. Wrong is wrong and right is right.
There is no gray, just black and white.
And if it took the blood back then, well, it still does. We just gotta tell it. We just gotta tell it like it was. Tell it like it was.
Oh, we just gotta
be seated. Thank you so much. And while Brother Todd is making his way up here, I'm going to give you my microphone, Brother Todd, so hang tight for a minute. I have some thank yous to say. I've been a little quiet tonight, letting all these other folks, you know. But Brother James Bolton and the church at Free Life, if you go to church here, would you like to raise your hand? I know they had another function going on, but Brother James has been so hospitable. It's been just amazing. And I wanted to say thank you. I think you guys need to show him by a round of applause how much you appreciate the building. Yes. Amen. Brother James is right back here. Raise your hand, Brother James. I would have asked him to introduce this next song, but I told David whenever I pitched this song to him, I said, I want it sung with some, I want passion. I feel this song. I knew I couldn't sing it, but I knew David could sing it. But I wanted the introduction to be passionate. And I said, you think Brother Todd would do it? And he said, I'll ask him. So I'm just turning it over to you. I know that you've got something, and I really, really appreciate you coming tonight and enduring everybody else. You know, I know I'm teasing you. I know the Truth Infusion go to your church, but I appreciate everybody that has come out. Thank you from our heart to yours. Thank you. Thank you. In fact, we had some people that were so excited about getting here, they came a month early. And they looked over here at the parking lot. There weren't nobody. There wasn't any buses. There was nobody out in the parking lot. They said, I think we might have the wrong date, but they're here tonight. Thank you for showing up on the right night and all of y'all together. I'm going to give this microphone to Brother Todd Reed. Make him welcome here tonight. Redwater First Baptist.
Don't you appreciate Miss Rhonda and all this crew? Amen. Hey, I'm not, I know some of you are probably nervous. The Brother Todd's going to preach. I'm not going to preach. All I'm going to do tonight is share with you just straight scripture. I just want to share the scripture as the song begins. Are we ready, bro? Let's do it. Revelation chapter 1, verse 7 says, "Behold, he comes, and every eye will see him." Matthew chapter 25, verse 31 says that the Son of Man will come with the clouds in his glory. And it says that every eye will see him, but he'll come with the holy angels. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 2 says that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night. But 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 says this, "The Lord himself shall descend with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first, and then we who are alive and who remain will be caught up with it together in the clouds, and so shall we meet the Lord in the air and be with him forever, forever, forever."
He's coming back. Listen for the trumpet. He's coming back.
cue, y'all. All right. Opportunity to someone that needs you, that may need a closer walk. You realize Christ is coming. It's not just a myth. It's not just a fairy tale. You have felt the Spirit of God tonight, and it has quickened you, and you know I'm telling right. And this is your opportunity. Now is the day of salvation, the 25th of February. It is your day. And Lord, I'm asking you if there's one in the house for them to raise their hand so that I'll know who I'm praying for. If you do not know him as your personal Savior and you want to know him tonight, this is your time. Softly and tenderly, Jesus calls every time we come together because he does not want any to perish. And he wants to make sure that you've got the blood applied. We've talked about being free. We've talked about the blood tonight. And I want you to know that he is a chain breaker and he will take your burden and he will lay them down. He's already got them. I thank you so much for this group of people. I thank you, Lord. Go with each one of them. Go with each one. If there be one here tonight, Lord, that didn't raise their hand or acknowledge that you're dealing with them, don't let them sleep good. Let them be miserable till they find somebody that'll pray with them. Thank you, Lord. I am so thankful. I know you as my personal Savior. Yes, God. Thank you for each person that was here tonight and every member, every group, everything that has been done to glorify you. We give you praise and honor. Watch over these people in Jesus' name. Amen. You are dismissed.